Second type of problem to do before the end of class today is a problem where we're still going to think about slicing. We're still going to think about delta V as approximately something involving delta X. And we're still going to let delta X go to zero and get an integral. But it's not a solid of rotation. Instead, it's a solid with defined cross sections. An example will hopefully make this more clear. Let's try to make a three-dimensional picture right away. So I'm going to draw a line looking about like this. And you need to pretend that's coming out of the screen at you. That's the x-axis coming towards you. And a little to your right. So I'm trying to draw this with perspective. And a y-axis kind of going into the screen like that, say. And a third three-dimensional axis, say going upward. Oh, we could label that with, say, z, but we don't have to. I'm trying to draw the three-dimensional solid right away. The x, y axes are in some plane that might be worth trying to sketch. Say about like that. Now let's use the exact same function as before, y equals x squared, and let me draw it in that plane about like this, say. But I'm drawing it kind of with perspective. Right? It's like going into the screen there. Y equals x squared. Technically, if I allowed z to be anything, that would be more than just this curve. It would be a bunch of curves stacked on top of each other. But I'm just focused on the curve in the xy plane. Let me draw this line to 2. This over here would be 4, though that's not necessary to know. Here's what I want to imagine. I want to imagine a solid sitting here above this region. And the solid is shaped in such a way that if I slice that region with a knife perpendicular to the x-axis, that the slices, if I look at them head on, will look like squares. The cross sections will be squares. For example, if I sliced, say, right here, if that was the value of x where I sliced, what would the cross section look like? Draw a line. I want the solid to be above this region. The cross section is going to look like a square. This is going to be the bottom of the square. What do the other sides look like? If you draw that carefully, it looks about like this. I'm trying to draw it again with perspective. Something about like that will be that cross section. If I draw one over here, when x is 2, it's going to be a pretty big square. I need to draw my vertical lines first. If I draw one over here, it's going to be a pretty small square. If you try to draw a bunch of these, slowly you start to see in your imagination a solid. That's kind of a weird horn-like thing. Let's see. Oops, put more over here. Not expecting perfection in your drawing, just something reasonable. And that's all I can achieve as well as reasonable. That's the solid that I'm trying to find the volume of. And it's set up in such a way that it's not too hard. I mean, I could try to come up with examples that would be crazy hard, but we're fine with things that are not too hard. Again, slice it. Your typical cross section is going to be a thin slice with a certain width that's small, call it delta x. That, by the way, is an x. It's not a plus sign. I drew it kind of slanted. What's the volume of this going to be? Delta V. It's not a cylinder anymore. You might say it's a really, really thin box on its side. Its volume is not going to involve pi. It's not going to be pi r squared times the height. It's going to be just the side squared times the height. What should I call the side? Oh, how about S? Actually, might make sense to call it Y, but I'll call it S for side length. The volume of such a thin slice is going to be approximately S squared times delta X. Why approximately? Because the true sides of the slice are not going to be horizontal. They're going to be curved, at least at the along the top and along the right side for that matter. I'm approximating the curved sides with straight sides. Once again, I need to figure out how S depends on X. I'm going to integrate with respect to X. That's got the delta in front of it. It's actually the same thing as the previous one. In the previous example, R was X squared. In this one, S is X squared. Right, because it's this distance here, which is the same as the distance between this point and this point. And that's the Y coordinate of that point, which in terms of X is X squared. There's my volume, small volume of the thin slice. So the total volume of the solid is the sum of the small volumes, which will be approximately the sum of things like this, which are Riemann sums for a certain integral. I now let delta X go to zero again and get a total volume that can magically be found by an integral. Again, it's not magic, I just like to pretend. Integrate x to the fourth dx. What is the interval of integration? It's the same as the one on x. X goes from 0 to 2. And this is going to give exactly 32/5 without the pi. 1/5 x to the fifth from 0 to 2, that'll be 32/5. That'll be 6.4 for the volume. Okay. This is not an easy skill for most people. It's something to definitely work out. And even if you're not an artist, do your best to make reasonable drawings. And if it says draw the cross section, then draw the cross section. In this case, the cross section is a square cross section. I'm probably going to give you one problem where a cross section is maybe a circle with rotations as a circle, maybe a disc, or I meant to say semicircle is what I meant to say. I might give you one where the cross section is a semicircle, half of a circle. All right. Have a good day.